BCUninstaller is a free and open source program for the automatic removal of applications. Many of you may wonder, why would you install a special program for uninstalling applications when Windows already offers that option? The main reason is that uninstalling programs through the Apps and Features option in Windows is not the most efficient method. Often, after uninstalling this way, various remnants or the traces of the program remain on the computer. This can lead to a slowdown of the operating system, which may eventually require a reinstallation of Windows itself. The advantage of BCUninstaller is that, unlike Windows, it removes all remnants when uninstalling programs, including registry entries and hidden files left by the program. It allows for the simultaneous removal of multiple programs based on a list created by the user, as well as the removal of programs that come pre-installed with the Windows operating system. When you visit the official website, the link will be in the video description, you will notice that you have two options for downloading, or two websites through which you can download this application. Additionally, since this is an open source project, you can review the code by clicking on the link that leads to GitHub. After downloading the program and starting the installation, you will be presented with two options. You can install it on your computer or as a portable version. I will choose the first option, the standard installation on the computer. But if you want to use this program on multiple computers without needing to install it each time, you can select the second option, the portable version. In that case, you can install it on a USB drive, which you can use as needed on different computers. Upon the first launch, the program will perform a scan to detect applications installed on the computer. At the very beginning, you will have the option to customize the program to your needs in 6 steps, starting with selecting the language to be used. The default language is English, but you can change it if you wish. Next, you will choose how the list of programs will be displayed. Of course, the option you select or skip at the beginning can be changed later. For example, in this case, I will intentionally skip checking the Select Using Checkboxes option, so we can check it later. You will also have the option to specify whether you want to see system and protected components. You can highlight invalid uninstallers and choose to show unregistered applications in the list. You can decide whether you want the application to update automatically, whether you want to send anonymous statistics, and see user ratings for the applications. Finally, click the Finish Setup to complete the configuration. What you will likely notice upon the first launch is that the names of the applications are marked in different colors. The color depends on the type of the application and the certificate it uses. In the lower right corner, you can see the color legend. For example, green indicates applications with a verified certificate, red indicates application with unregistered certificate. On the left side, you will see the search option if you want to search for an application by name, as well as several different methods for narrowing down the list of displayed applications. For example, you can display only Windows Store applications or only applications that run at startup. I will now check the Select using checkboxes option that I initially skipped. When you find the application you want to uninstall, for example Skype, right-click on the program name, you will see three options for removal: uninstall, uninstall quietly, and uninstall manually. If you select the first option, the program will display the name of the application you have marked for removal and will ask you to confirm that you want to proceed. Click on Continue, after which the program will check if the application is running in the background and determine if it needs to be shut down for the uninstallation to continue. Then you will have the option to adjust the removal settings. If you are certain that you will no longer need this program, you can uncheck the option Create a restore point before uninstalling. If this option remains checked, the program will create a backup, allowing you to restore the application if you change your mind. After you click Continue again, the program will give you a brief overview of the settings, check to see if everything is as you want it to be, and click on Begin Uninstallation to start the removal process. When the process is complete, you will receive a notification "Task finished," indicating that the main program has been removed. When you click Close, the program will ask you if you want to scan for remnants of the program, in other words, all files, folders, and registry entries left behind by the program. Click Yes. After the scan, you will receive a list of everything that remains from the program. Mark everything you want to delete. The only case where you might not want to delete all remnants is when it comes to related programs, as removing one program could cause another related program to stop working. After you check and mark everything you want to delete, click on Delete Selected. After you click on Delete Selected, the program will prompt you to confirm whether you want to create a backup before deletion. If you wish to create a backup, click on Create. If not, click on Don't Create. Once the deletion is complete, the program will automatically perform another scan. If everything has been successfully removed, you will be returned to the main screen, where you can verify that the application is no longer listed. In addition to removing individual applications, the program provides the option to uninstall multiple applications simultaneously. Simply mark all the applications you wish to delete, right-click, and select the Uninstall Quietly option. You can also choose this option from the top menu. The removal process is the same regardless of whether you are uninstalling one or multiple applications. The third option for removal is uninstall manually. If you select this option, you will receive a list of all files and folders used by the specific program. If you choose this option, pay attention to the Confidence segment, which indicates whether a given file or folder is marked as good or questionable. If a file is marked as good, it means it is exclusively used by the program you want to uninstall. On the other hand, if a file is marked as questionable, it indicates that it's also used by another related program, and removing it could potentially cause the related program to stop functioning. Files marked as good will be automatically checked, while you will need to manually check all other files. The program gives you the flexibility to decide what you want to keep and what you want to remove. Another advantage of this program is that it allows you to see all applications that run with Windows operating system and determine which one you want to block and which one you want to allow. You can do this by clicking on Tools and then on Open Startup Manager. You will receive a list where you can see the application name, who signed the application, whether it is a service or a task, the application location, and most importantly, whether it currently runs at the startup. If yes appears next to the application in the enabled segment, it means the application starts with the operating system. You can change this by right-clicking and deselecting the enabled option. For these changes to take effect, you will need to restart your computer. Additionally, if you have any portable applications, you can uninstall them by clicking on Tools, then Uninstall from Directory, and select the location where the application is located. Although portable applications are not installed, this does not mean that running them will not create files and folders necessary for the program's functions. You can use this option to safely and efficiently remove a portable application. Thanks to everyone who took the time to watch this video. I hope you find it useful or at least informative.